And we were going to this Good Friday, a Tenebrae service. And the word of Tenebrae comes from Latin word and means a darkness. And through this service, we meditate on the passion of Jesus Christ. So this time, I invite you to rise so we might join together in our greeting, which is responsive.
But you can if you want.
What?
Kind of awkward from here, but you can't just stand up.
God is alive, in whom there's no darkness at all.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world.
And the darkness rather
than light. So there is opening heavens, the old world at the cross. In our hymn number 504.
True.
Please join us in Good Friday prayer. Almighty God, your Son Jesus Christ
was lifted high upon the cross,
that he might draw the whole world to himself. Grant that we, who glory in his death for our salvation, and glory in his call to take up our cross and follow him, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I told you that I am he. If you are looking for me, then let these men go. This happened so that the words he had spoken would be fulfilled. I have not lost one of those you gave me. Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's servant, cutting off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus. Jesus commanded Peter, put your sword away. Shall I not drink the cup the Father has given me? Then the detachment of soldiers with its commander and the Jewish officers arrested Jesus. They bound him and brought him first to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jewish leaders that it would be good if one man died for the people.
Known to the high priest, He went with Jesus into the high priest's courtyard, but Peter had to wait outside at the door. The other disciple who was known to the high priest came back and spoke to the servant girl on duty there and brought Peter in. "You aren't one of this man's disciples too, are you?" she asked Peter. He replied, "I am not." It was cold, and the servants and officials stood around a fire they had made to keep warm. Peter was also standing with them, warming himself. Meanwhile, the high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching. "I have spoken openly to the world," Jesus replied. "I always taught in synagogues or at temple, where all the Jews come together. I said nothing in secret. Why question me? Ask those who heard me. Surely they know what I said." When Jesus said this, one of the officials nearby slapped him in the face. "This is the way you answer the high priest," he demanded. "If I said something wrong," Jesus replied, "testify as to what is wrong. But if I spoke the truth, why did you strike me?" Then Annas sent him bound to the high priest.
Thank you. 38. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself. They asked him, "You are not also one of his disciples, are you?" He denied it and said, "I am not." One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, "Did I not see him in the garden with him?" Again, Peter denied it, and at that moment, the cock crowed. Then when they took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters, it was early in the morning. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so as to avoid the ritual defilement and be able to eat Passover. So Pilate went out to them, and he said, "What accusation do you bring against this man?" They answered, "If this man were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you." Pilate said, "Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law." The Jews replied, "We are not permitted to put anyone to death." This was to fulfill what Jesus had said when he indicated the kind of death he was to die. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again and summoned Jesus and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So are you a king?" And Jesus answered, "You say that I'm a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Pilate asked him, "What is the truth?" After he said this, he went out to the Jews and told them, "I find no case against him."
Yeah. you have the custom that I should release someone to you at the Passover. Do you therefore want me to release you to the King of the Jews? Chapter 19, verse 11. Jesus answered him, you would have no authority over me at all unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore, he who delivered me over to you has the greater sin.
You get this.
Jesus answered him.
Okay.
Yeah. You have a custom that I release someone for you at the Passover. You want me to release for you the King of the Jews? They shouted in reply, not this man, but
Barabbas.
Now Barabbas was a rebel. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. And the soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him saying, Hail, King of the Jews! And striking him on the face, Pilate went out again and said to them, Look, I am bringing him out to you to let you know that I find no case against him. So Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. Pilate said to them, Behold the man. When the chief priests and the police saw him, they shouted, Crucify him, crucify him. Pilate said to them, Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no case against him. The Jews answered him, We have a law, and according to the law, he ought to be died, because he has claimed to be the Son of God. Now, when Pilate heard this, he was more afraid than ever. He entered his headquarters again and answered Jesus, Where are you from? But Jesus gave him no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, Do you refuse to speak to me? Do you not know that I have the power to release you and the power to crucify you? Jesus answered him, You would have no power over me unless it had been given to you from above. Therefore, the one who handed me over to you is guilty of a greater sin.
Thank you.
verses 12 to 24, the first accounting of the crucifixion. From then on, Pilate tried to release him, but the Jews cried out, "You release this man, you are no friend of the emperor. Everyone who claims to be a king sets himself against the emperor." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus outside and sat on the judge's bench at a place called the Stone Pavement, or in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover, and it was about noon. He said to the Jews, "Here is your king." They cried, away with him, crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priest answered, "We have no king but the emperor." Then he handed him over to be crucified. So they took Jesus and carried him across by himself. He went out to what is called the place of the skull, which in Hebrew was called Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with two others, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. Then the chief priest of the Jews said to Pilate, "Do not write the King of the Jews." But the man said, "I am the King of the Jews." Pilate answered, What I have written, I have written." When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it, to see who will get it." This was to fulfill the scripture, saying, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots."
Thank you. and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." This he said to the disciple. Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. After this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to finish the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop, and it held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received his wine, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head.
In the front, there will be a nail near the cross, and you will receive our nail when you come forward. So as you feel it between your fingers, a reflect on when you have felt hurt or humiliation, and feel God's presence with you as you live with what hurt. And on this darkest of days, we remember the death of Jesus of Nazareth. And confessing our participation today in the scene of this world, we come forward to the cross, and we are invited to place our fears and judgment, our guilt and our worries at the foot of the cross. Now we are promised forgiveness and hope. So this time I invite you to come forward to the cross and put a nail on it. Put your heart, your humiliation, your guilt, and worries and fears on the cross. And Jesus Christ is taking them by his blood.
Let your blood on your hands.
of America, and who was a disciple of Jesus through a secret one because of his fear of the Jews, asked Pilate to let him take away the body of Jesus. Pilate gave him permission, so he came and removed his body. Nicodemus, who had at first come to Jesus by night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. They took the body of Jesus and wrapped it with the spices and linen cloths, according to the burial custom of the Jews. Now there was in a garden in the place that he was crucified, and in the garden there was a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. And so because it was the Jewish day of preparation and the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus.
the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him. And without Him, not one thing came into being. But as come into being in Him was life. The light was the light of all people. The light has come into the world. And people love darkness rather than light. Because of these were evil. Go in peace. May Jesus Christ, who for our sake became obedient unto death, even death on the cross, keep you and strengthen you this night and forever.